हेलो एवरीवन, वी आर गोइंग टू परफॉर्म आवर नेक्स्ट प्रैक्टिकल ऑफ सब्जेक्ट CNE, दैट इज प्रैक्टिकल नंबर 8, डिटरमाइन रेगुलेशन एंड इफिशियंसी ऑफ सिंगल फेज ट्रांसफार्मर बाय डायरेक्ट लोड. सो वी नो दैट इफिशियंसी इज आउटपुट पावर अपॉन इनपुट पावर. इज हाउ द ट्रांसफार्मर इफिशियंटली ट्रांसफर इट्स ऑल ऑफ इट्स पावर. सो इन आइडियल कंडीशन, सपोज वी गिव अ प्राइमरी वोल्टेज, प्राइमरी इनपुट पावर इज सपोज 100. सो आइडियली इट शुड ट्रांसफर द ऑल द पावर टू द सेकेंडरी, दैट इज 100. सो इन आइडियल कंडीशन लॉसेस आर 0, बट इन प्रैक्टिकल केस देर इज अ सम लॉसेस इन ट्रांसफार्मर, दैट इज आयन लॉसेस और कॉपर लॉसेस. सो इफ वी गिव इनपुट 100 वोल्ट, सो द सेकेंडरी दैट इज आउटपुट पावर इज समवॉट लेसर देन द इनपुट पावर. सो सेम वे वी ऑल्सो कैलकुलेट रेगुलेशन बाय कैलकुलेटिंग द नो लोड सेकेंडरी वोल्टेज टू द फुल लोड और लोडेड सेकेंडरी वोल्टेज. सो दिस इज द एक्चुअल कनेक्शन और सर्किट डायग्राम ऑफ दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट. सो दिस इज अ इनपुट सप्लाई, दिस इज अ सिंगल फेज वेरिएक, द वन ऑफ द सिंगल पॉइंट ऑफ सिंगल फेज वेरिएक इज कनेक्टेड टू द primary of the transformer through ammeter and wattmeter. So this point, one point is connected to the ammeter, and ammeter second point is again connected to the wattmeter M point. The wattmeter M and C point are short circuited, and L point is connected to the transformer primary having larger number of turns. So this is a step down transformer which having a primary having large number of turns and secondary having less number of turns. The secondary point of primary winding is connected to the single phase variac. So in order to measure the voltage across primary, the voltmeter V is connected across the primary of the transformer, and wattmeter V point is connected to the return path of the primary. Similarly, in secondary connection, the secondary is connected to the load through the ammeter and wattmeter. So one of the secondary winding is connected to the A2 point, and A2 secondary point, second point of A2 or ammeter is connected to the wattmeter M point. So again, wattmeter M and C point are short circuited, and L is connected to the load, and second point of load is connected to the remaining point of the secondary. In order to measure the secondary voltage, we connected a voltmeter across the load, and the voltage point or V point of the wattmeter is connected to the return path of the secondary. So this is a circuit diagram. This is the actual circuit diagram or actual connection. So this is a single phase variac. So it should have an input supply here. One of the input point or single phase variac point is connected to an ammeter, and ammeter second point of ammeter is connected to the primary wattmeter M point. So wattmeter M point and C point, that is M and C point, are short circuited through this wire, and L point is connected. This L point is connected to the transformer primary. So in order to get, there are two sections in transformer primary and transformer secondary. So in order to get a transformer having large number of turns, so we connected this two section in series. So second point is connected, second point of our primary of transformer is connected to the or return to the supply. In order to measure the voltage across the primary, we connected a voltmeter across the primary. Similarly, secondary. So secondary point is connected to a load through an ammeter. The ammeter second point is connected to an wattmeter watt meter. So watt meter M point and C point are short circuited. Again L point of watt meter is connected to a load. The load, second point of the load is connected or written to the transformer secondary. So this point is written to a transformer secondary. So in order to measure voltage across the secondary side, we connected and voltmeter across the secondary. And voltage terminal of wattmeter is connected to the again return path of the secondary side. So this wattmeter is having here it is having 5 ampere parallel connection, so it having a 5 ampere maximum current because it has a two current rating 2.5 and 5 ampere. So this connection shows this is a parallel connection, so it should have a maximum current, so 5 ampere, and we connected a 250 volt point. So this watt meter having multiplying factor, that is 5 ampere maximum into 250 divided by 312.5. What is 312.5? So it is the maximum deflection possible of this watt meter. So we get a multiplying factor of 4. So if it shows here 100, so it actually transfers the power, that is 100 into 4, 400. Similarly, this second watt meter I am connected to a voltage point of 150, and again it is a parallel connection. So it is a parallel connection, and so it having multiplying factor, that is 150 volt and 5 ampere. For 151 and 5 ampere, 1 is a multiplying factor. So if it shows here 100 watt, so it actually consumes 100. So we are going to take some reading. So I am going to take reading I2. I2 is having 1.4 ampere. So I am writing 1.4 ampere. V2 is 112 ampere. I1 current is 0.8. W1 is around 44. Around 44. So it shows 44 into 4. So 44 into 4, 176 watt. And W2 shows around 165. So it shows 160. So similar way, we are going to take another reading. So secondary input current is 2.77. V2 voltage is 109. I1 current is 1.46. W1 is around 87.5, this approximately 88 into 4. So 88 into 4 means 352 watt. W2 is around 310 watt. So these are the actual observation readings of this transformer, of this factor. So from this formula, we are able to find the efficiency and voltage regulation. Thank you.